जय श्री राम। वेलकम टू एस्ट्रोलॉजी विद अभिलाषा। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग योर दरकारक इन डिफरेंट हाउसेज। यू कैन ऑल्सो टेक दिस एज योर सेवेंथ लॉर्ड इन डिफरेंट हाउसेज। रिजल्ट्स विल बी वेरी सिमिलर, राइट? सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो इफ योर दरकारक इज इन द फर्स्ट हाउस, द फर्स्ट थिंग you should understand with this placement is that your husband or your wife gonna be really interested in your life, in your personality, the way you look, the way you carry yourself, your appearance, everything. They would be kind of dominating in this field. And you can also say that once you get married, your spouse would affect your total existence in a grand great way. If Dharakaraka is in Lagna, so you understand, your spouse, your husband or wife comes and sits on your mind, right? So they are governing technically each and every sphere of your life. This is, you can say, this makes a very passionate couple, this kind of placement. But sometimes it get very taxing, and very, a person feels like he is prisoned or caged by his spouse. So this is also an attribute which you should understand, the pros and cons of your Dharakaraka sitting in your Lagna. He or she will greatly impact your life, your personality in totality. The way people look at you would be affected after you get married. They will change the perceptions of others regarding you once you get married. They will govern your thought process, your outlook, your point of view. Everything will be changed when Dharakaraka sits in the Lagna. You yourself would succumb or surrender to your partner. And if you do not, that would create a rift in your married life. So if your seventh lord or your Dharakaraka sits in your Lagna, you should understand that the karma of your marriage is to be fully devoted to your spouse and let them take the lead. Let them decide the path of your marriage. Correct? So this is how you should understand when Dharakaraka or the seventh lord sits in your Lagna. That is the first house. Right? Now let's take Dharakaraka to the second house. So when this planet's, the planet which is your Dharakaraka or the seventh lord sits in the second house, once you get married, your finances, your assets, the way you speak, your family, everything takes a change. You can expect that your spouse would be directly involved in your investment, in your financial matters, in your family matters, in the way you speak, address something. That everything should be affected once you get married if Dharakaraka is your second lord. To an extent, they would even impact your food choices here. If you are a vegetarian, you might become a non-vegetarian or vice versa. So every attribute of the second house would be, reignited once you get married if your seventh lord or Dharakaraka sits in the second house. You might be a very outspoken person, but suddenly after marriage you see people becoming very introvert or very less talkative. they hardly talk and they were a chatterbox once in lifetime. So you understand that, okay, this change always comes after marriage, and you should understand the placement of Dharakarka and change in the person after marriage. Sometime it is also seen that this is not a very conducive placement for the seventh lord. If seventh lord is in second house, or if Venus is in second house, Venus is also the Karaka of marriage. So I'm taking a collective approach. I hope you understand the vastness of the subject and adhere to me. Please try and understand what I'm talking about. So if Dharakarka is in second house, or if Venus is in second house, or if the seventh lord is in second house, specifically if the seventh lord and Venus sits in the second house, it is not very conducive for the marital bliss. It is generally seen that there is some disharmony in marriage because it's become eighth to the seventh house, right? So Venus being placed there, or seventh lord being placed there, is not very good for the marital life, though it is very good for your financial conditions, but not for marriage. Right, so if your Dharakarka is in the second house, you are a person who is very, you know, influenced by the way somebody appears, by the way your spouse appears. His or her physical appearance would be a matter of concern for you and for them as well. Correct? So that is all about the second house. Now, if your Dharakarka is in the third house, the first and foremost thing you should understand that this placement, the third house placement of Dharakarka, will bring a change in your pattern of luck after marriage. Your luck will change after you get married. Good or bad depends on the dignity of your Dharakarka. Correct? You will have a surge of efforts in your day-to-day life after you get married. Somebody who's very lethargic or lazy, once they get married and if their Dharakarka happens to be in the third house, they will feel a surge of power. Every lethargy, every procrastination and every postponing of events will run away from their life. They will become a very focused person, a person who will believe in their own efforts. This will be a very good change which come after your marriage if Dharakarka sits in the third house. It will increase your effort. So sometime it can be a bit troublesome for you as well, because for everything you have to put 200% of effort to achieve everything. If your Dharakarka sits in the third house, they will also after marriage, your communication style will also be affected. It is also a great possibility that you would meet your spouse through social media or through a digital platform. If your Dharakarka is in third house, there are high chances that you meet your spouse through a digital platform, social networking sites, etc. Or while traveling, while a short travel, that is also a possibility. Now, if your Dharakarka is placed in the fourth house, so after marriage, the occupation of your spouse will take a drastic change. Depending upon the malefic and the benefic aspect of the planet, the dignity of the planet, you can calculate that how will you affect the occupation of your spouse in a good manner or in a bad manner, but that would take place if your Dharakarka is in your fourth house. If Dharakarka becomes a malefic and sits in the fourth house, it can also show that there will be disharmony among your mother and your spouse. So sometimes we see if Dharakarka sits in the fourth house and it is a malefic, after marriage the person has to leave his home and live separately from their parents. For male, I'm talking, because female, it's very common nowadays. It is a common thing that male, a female has to go to his her husband's house. So that, I'm not talking about that, but yeah, for the males, if a Dharakarka is a malefic and sits in the fourth house, it is highly probable that you have to move away from your family. But your comfort will always lies in your spouse. If your Dharakarka or your seventh lord is sitting in the fourth house, the comfort of your heart will always be with your spouse. However, you'll be fighting, you'll be having disagreements, difference of opinion, but at the end of it, the solace would be with your spouse only. So that is one thing. After marriage, you might have to change the place of living. That is one thing. Right. So a very significant event with your mother will happen after marriage if the Dharakarka is sitting in the fourth house. Right, and if the Dharakarka is in the fifth house, so now your spouse would be all about authority. He or she will be a very authoritarian kind of person, very inclined toward their lineage, toward the orthodox pattern of living. Very high-headed spouse you'd be getting. And those kind of spouse who, as soon as they get married, they start thinking about the child and progeny, that will also be the case if your Dharakarka or your seventh lord is in the fifth house. You can also say that if your Dharakarka is in the fifth house, it will effect, right? So now let's come, if your Dharakarka is in the sixth house, so sixth house is not a very good house for placement of your Dharakarka or your seventh lord. If a seventh lord is placed in the sixth house, it is highly indicative of a divorce or a something which doesn't let you enjoy the bliss of marriage, if not divorce. Then there will be an issue which will not let you enjoy the bliss of marriage. If your Dharakarka or your seventh lord is in the sixth house, you will be so occupied or preoccupied by the daily course of living, your daily rituals, your daily routine will be such that you won't be able to enjoy your marital life. There will be a fight on small issues. You and your spouse would always be on a competitive platform. You would compete with each other if your Dharakarka is in your sixth house. So that is, I think, not a very healthy atmosphere for a marriage. So that's how you conclude if your Dharakarka is in sixth house. If I take a positive aspect, I can say that your spouse would be very routine-oriented kind of a person. He or she may be involved in some charitable work or some kind of social work, NGO-related stuff they'll be involved into if your seventh lord or your Dharakarka is in the sixth house. To be honest, this is a very challenging position. You'll be challenged by your spouse itself, which is not a very good condition to have. Now, if your Dharakarka is in seventh itself, then it is the opposite of what I told you when your Dharakarka was in Lagna. Now your Dharakarka comes into the seventh house. So that person will be very social, first of all. Will be very enterprising, highly high libido. He or she will be, you know, kind of your missing part that we look for in our spouse. The yin and yang kind of a situation will arise if your Dharakarka is in your seventh house. You would face the world in totality. Togetherness would be the prime focus of your spouse and you as well. A very stubborn spouse can be indicated if Dharakarka sits in the seventh house. One who is strong-headed, who knows what he is talking about, very clear and focused kind of a person, very romantic also. A very romantic spouse you'd be getting if Dharakarka is in seventh. You would be very attracted towards your spouse if this is a placement. Enjoying anything after marriage alone would become a task for you if your Dharakarka is in the seventh house, because the complimenting factor that person will provide would be unavoidable now after marriage. So this has to be the scene. And now if your Dharakarka is in the eighth house, so you can say that the person you're gonna get married would be from a very stable financial status, financial very sound. He or she would get some major part of your inheritance as well. Your spouse could be very secretive along with this placement. Something would be very unpredictable about your spouse if your Dharakarka sits in the 8th house. A major transformation would come in your life after your marriage due to your spouse. This is what this placement signifies. This is also a very tough placement, I would say. But still, it has some good points attached to it. So it's a mix of, you know, good and bad. So you can enjoy, but with its share of negativity. And it also makes the combination of getting a beautiful spouse. So if Venus sits in your 8th house, right, or your 2nd house, aspecting the 8th house, that makes a combination of having a very beautiful, good-looking spouse in your native comparison, right? That is one point which I would like to add. Now, if your Dharakarka sits in the 9th house, the spouse would be like a father figure to you, like a guru to you. He or she would influence your travel activity after marriage. He or she might suggest you to take up higher studies after marriage. We see couples, advising each other regarding the progress and taking up higher studies. That is the scenario when Dharakarka sits in the 9th house. You could marry by the choice of your father, which is very prominent in this combination. And rather, you should, if Dharakarka sits in the 9th house, you should marry with the consent of your father. That would be really life-changing for you and your luck. So always have an influence of your father if Dharakarka sits in the 9th house in context to your marriage. Always take his advice. Right. So if Dharakarka sits in the 10th house, now this position of your Dharakarka indicates that after marriage, your social status gonna change for good or bad, that depends on the dignity of the planet, of the state of the 10th house and the 10th lord. But marriage would be that event which will affect your social status. Rather, I can say you would marry for the sake of your social status if your Dharakarka is in the 10th house. Your karma lies with your spouse. If 7th lord or Dharakarka sits in the 10th house, please be aware that the karma of your life is highly attached with your spouse. So good or bad, try to stick with your spouse just to sail through the sea of karma for which we are here in this world, right? This can easily affect your job, career, etc. after marriage. This placement would also affect your comforts, your comfort, the way of living. Your household would be affected or influenced deeply by this placement of Dharakarka in 10th house. Right. So that is all. And for the 11th house placement of Dharakarka, you can get your spouse from your friend circle, from an acquaintance you already know from ages, can turn into your spouse. Gains, profit would be the theme of your marriage. How much can you gain from each other? That can be on the level of evolvement as a human. That profit or gain can be regarding how you evolve as a human. Or you can take it to the monetary aspect or the materialistic aspect of life. Your personality, evolvement of your personality, that is also attributed if Dharakarka is placed in the 11th house. But the major theme would be gains through marriage. Gain through your spouse. That can be the materialistic side of the world or the knowledge, the evolvement as a human being, as a person, can also be the aspect you should see. That depends on person to person and the planet which becomes your Dharakarka, the Rashi which falls in the 11th house, right? The D9 your Dharakarka occupies. That also makes the difference. You understand that D1 placement of your Dharakarka is how would you like your spouse to be. And the D9 placement is the actual thing you will get as an actual person you will get as your spouse. How that person would be, should be seen from the D9, and how you expect your spouse to be should be seen from the D1. So this is the subtle difference which you should understand. But the result should be the amalgamation of both the things and not seen in singularity but in togetherness. So gains, profits, upliftment, your friend circle, this is very important in this placement. When the 7th lord is placed in the 11th house or the Dharakarka, this also 11th house also denotes multiplicity. So this placement can also show multiple spouse, multiple marriages. So it's a bit tricky one. You should check accordingly if there are a combination of divorce, etc. So you can tell if your 7th lord or your Dharakarka is sitting in that 11th house. It shows that you can have multiple marriages as well. So this is one thing. So if your Dharakarka sits in the 12th house, I would only talk about the positive part, which is you can meet your spouse in foreign land. Or by foreign land, I mean a native, not a native. Not a person who's born in your clan, somebody who's from a different lineage, different clan, caste and culture can also mean a foreigner, like a person born in South and you yourself are born in the north of India or like that. So